our speaker.
Good morning. Am I audible? Okay. So, good morning all. It's fun to be here. Good to see young faces and a lot of faces here on Saturday morning. Thanks to PCMC, my Saturday morning also started pretty early. We had JC talking about the fitness. We had Goki talking about the whole health side of it. I'm going to talk about something a little different. Looking at these pictures, you might get some idea what I'm going to talk about. I'm just going to talk about one fun part, which is there with us since we are born. It's called sports. The session will be around sportsy, and why I call it sportsy, because I find sports very sexy, to be very honest. So it's sportsy. By Siddharth Deshmukh, Sid Deshmukh. I'll be just give a brief background about myself. I'm a failed athlete. I've been a competitive athlete while growing up. I played a lot of sports, represented at different level. But a very unfortunate incident that happened for me, I had a bad shoulder injury, and at the age of 16, 15 and a half, my playing career got over. I could not play beyond that. So I always call myself a failed athlete. I never called myself a failed sportsman. I called myself a failed athlete. I'm a force engineer. Grew up in 90s, guys. So if there was no, and born in doctor's family. So if not doctor, then the second thing was for me to do something in science side of it. And growing in 90s, other than the nice Bollywood songs, what we had was computer science. So I'm a computer science graduate and did my couple of MBAs after that from SIBM, work with corporate for 10 to 12 years. But one thing was always there. Even though I was forced into doing all these activities, I was not enjoying what I was doing in my corporate life as well. And one thing was always pulling me back is, what am I doing for sports? I enjoy watching, I enjoy playing, I can't be playing at a competitive level, but what am I doing at that level? Coincidence, I just got a book on APJ Kalam, Dr. APJ Kalam, and something I'm just, I'm fascinated with what one of his statements that he talks about. The dreams is something that doesn't let you, that you watch in sleep. The dream is something that doesn't let you sleep. And guys, that is what was the transformation after 12 years spending in IT and management consulting. What I did, and this is not put in. I got the book when I came on stage right now. This is already there. So this is what I completely believe in. And if you have a dream, go for it. And that dream was I came into sports. I am a sportpreneur. It's a fancy term I created, right? The sports and entrepreneurship together is sportpreneur. And call me crazy, but after quitting my job and everything, I'm living my dream. And I dream to make it big. That is what my story is all about. I'm talking about what sports is for me. Sports is all about passion. Sports is about goals. Sports is about relentless training. Sports is about determination. Sports is about having discipline. Sports is also a very big factor which teaches you what happens when you fail. How to get the rejections. What do you do in your life when you do not achieve your goals? Everything sports teaches you. But that is one thing. If you look at the whole combination of sports, we understand one thing. You can't put limit on anything. The more you dream, the further you get. Any athlete is always trying to make a better version of himself or herself every next day. And that is what sports teaches you. So, yes, you need to be fit. You need to be healthy. But if you do not have the mindset of being there, starts with playing sports. It could be you played langdi, kabaddi, kho kho. atya patya, any kind of game that you don't talk about, right? It is, there's some physical activity happening in your life, and that is what you want to continue. That's why I always talk about what is sports is for me. Never give up. You will always have challenges in life, but never give up. That is one of the most important factors that sports teaches you. And this is what happened to me when I followed my dream. Yes, not every day people get to work, be close to this person that 1.3 billion people admire. And I work for him, I work with him, I do his brand management. Yes, I could have shown other pictures as well, the athlete I work with, and with no disrespect to them. But when I talk about this image, I know where I am. I am actually in the dream. I'm living my dream. That's why I want to show. But yes, I've been working with people like Adi Chauhan, India's. She's a prime face for India's footballing career. She's India's captain and goalkeeper. I work with Kedar Jadhav. I work with Mansi Joshi. She's a Paralympian and world number two para badminton player and recent world champion. I work with a lot of athletes. But yes, this is very close to me. He's called Mahi. My daughter's name is Mahi. There's no relation to that, but still, there's a lot of different thing is, that's why I show this image. What has sports has taught me? Big lecture, I'm not going to get into it. It is about antarprerna. I was reading one book which is about antarprerna and life of entrepreneurship. So what antarprerna means? Something that comes from within. It is antarprerna. And if you relate that to English, it is entrepreneurship, antarprerna. Just try to relate that. It sounds like, if you're playing dumb sharaj, it can be a sound like thing. That is what I talk about. That's what got me to what I am doing. And what I feel that what you can do in your life is just have a right goal. Have your passion and try to achieve that. It is something that will be there. Write something on your wall that I want to be here, I want to be there, and make it happen. If you really want to do something, yes, you will do it. But if you don't do it, you will find an excuse. So yeah, we end up finding excuse. So I am impossible become I am possible. That is what you should be striving for. It is not management statement. It is something that can make it happen. I'm just going to shift to, she's showing me number time, remaining time. So yes, I'm going to shift to the next topic. What is the sports ecosystem in India? Everybody wants to look at sports that differently, right? You look at IPL, you look at badminton, kabaddi, all those things. But what are the pillars of sports? Sports is completely, one of the biggest things that happens in sports is commercialization. There has to be money in sports for sports to grow. Why do you see that in India we are 1.3 billion people and we are just 2.3 billion sports contribute to GDP, where US is 400 million people and 80 billion is contributing to GDP. So when we are talking about these kind of number, we are three times bigger the size, but 148 times lesser the size on the revenue that can contribute to sports. So that's why the commercialization of sports is very, very, very important. Second thing I'm going to talk about is development of and through sports. I'm in PCMC, I have a really good opportunity discussing with Hardikar sir about what are the things that happening in PCMC. Guys, we are sitting in one of the most sports rich area in India. We have the per capita largest number of sports facilities in PCMC in India. How many of you actually know and use it? That is what the development of sports is all about. I think there are facilities available. Please go and do that. That is what the whole thing we are talking about. And I thought, Bhuvaneshwar, what is Odisha? Odisha becoming a sports state. You are talking about multiple cities becoming the sports city. What stops from us using this facility, maintaining it well for your own benefit? Be selfish. In return, government is there to have the facility and they will maintain it. But if you don't use it, why will they maintain it? Don't blame on government, you're not doing anything. Are you going and use those facilities? So understand, development of and through sports. Education in sports is very important. I've been part of a lot of education institute. We talk about sports. There are two things. One is at the higher level about how do you make the athletes employable beyond their playing career, and also teaching the grassroots development about the whole development. What that sports means to you? So understand what kind of programs we are running in community. I saw a lot of people with the white coat, the doctors getting ready for their routine. You have to push people to become sports maniacs. Go for sports, go for it. It will happen. The lifestyle will change. The education has to start from people who understand and want to enjoy sports. We are talking about sustainability of and through sports. The UN is talking about the United Nations Development Plan, the Sustainable Development Goal. There are 17 goals talking about women, empowerment, then nutrition, lot of 17 different goals. Why can't sports be a 18th goal there? What? Because that thing in the world which does not have boundaries, right? We know importance of sports. Why can't sports be sustainable? And we can bring sustainability through sports. I work with so many institutes where we work with the girls in football, because football is one sport where we can actually talk about overall development of girls that can happen through sports. We also train with a lot of underprivileged kids and the boys, where we focus on football as a development mechanism. That is what the sustainability is all about. We are talking about sustainability and through sports. Now you'll see a slide which has got a lot of activities happening. We are talking about, yes, a few other things. We are talking about this, we are talking about this, this, we are talking about this, we are talking about this. And everything on this slide is about those four slides we talked about: commercialization, education, development, and sustainability. There are foundations like Go Sports, Golden Go Sports. We are focusing on sports as a foundation. There are companies like SparUp, RunAdam, who are actually working towards providing technology to enable sports and athletes to build a whole ecosystem. There are leagues happening in India. We know success of IPL, ISL, Kabaddi, but there are, if you don't know, there are 14 leagues happening in India right now on multiple sports. Kho-kho is starting soon. So imagine what kind of value and what kind of importance that we actually can give to sports to make career into sports. And career into sports is not only about playing. And that is what I'm going to talk about. What beyond playing, these are the players everybody wants to see starting in next 30 days. This is what India lives for, right? Cricket, our religion, and Sachin is our God, and everything that we talk about, right? So we want to go beyond this. What is future? The theme of this event is future of festival. Festival of future. So when you're talking about future, what is the future of sport and in sport is? First thing, for you to have a future, you need to have a present. And for that present, you need to be a student, or you need to be a good student. Keep educating yourself for a better future. And that is why this I actually showcase this as my very favorite line, because I am a student of sports, student of this life every day. And that is what you're talking about. I'll just talk about a few lines which are going to be new areas in sports. We're talking about smart connected arenas, like when a sports facility becoming completely smart facility, where you get to experience something, the fan gets to experience a lot of activity that are happening in sports. We are talking about technology which are going to help athlete increase the performance. I'll give a small example. In one of the Tour de France, I forgot the name of the champion. He was not winning till a few stages. And one of the guys who were working with him as a scientist, he asked him to cut his ponytail. And after that, the guy actually started winning the next four stages. And if the thing was, the ponytail was actually going in as a distraction towards his aerodynamism. So he had to, the moment he cut the ponytail, his performance. Yes, it's not like because of ponytail, his performance increased. But I'm talking about the science which is behind this, the technologies kind of thing which impact us as an athlete. And the whole world is going crazy about can the full marathon run below two hours. So those are the technologies, the Adidas and Nikes of the world working on the shoes which are going to help you run better and faster and all those things. So this is the technology we are talking about. Wearable, non-wearable. Goki is sitting here, one of the biggest example from Indian, the Make in India and the big India story. We have Goki sitting here who is talking about the wearable. Also, there are something called non-wearable, which are non-intrusive. They monitor you without being on the body. So that is, I'm talking about wearable, non-wearable. Geo-linked broadcasting advertisement, right? Suppose the game of Premier League happening in London, and in India, we talk about something which is going to be the advertisement localized for Indian fans. So that is called geo-linked advertisement that we have. Away games looks like a home game. Imagine Barcelona is playing Real Madrid at Real Madrid Stadium, but if a fan can come at Barcelona Stadium and watch the whole game in holograms. Those kind of fun activities we are talking about. Sports apparel to assist the athlete. We were running from the banyan, not wearing anything to banyans to dry fit, aqua fit, everything that we are talking about. We are talking about those activities. Nutrition and supplements. Esports and gaming. Kind of, just to give you a number, we are going to have a 5 lakhs plus different kind of jobs in sports in 2 years from now. and multiple jobs are coming in areas which are not only technical but also in the ecosystem area. This is again, I know introduction required for Nelson Mandela. One thing that is very close to me, what he again says, sports has the power to change the world. It has the power to inspire. It has the power to unite people in the way that little else does. It speaks the youth language that they understand. You're talking about sports can create hope when there is a despair. It's more powerful than government in breaking down the racial norms. Understand racial barriers. Understand, guys, what it means. We are talking about a statement made by somebody who has fought for freedom, somebody has fought on racial discrimination, somebody has fought for inspiring youth. We are talking about, we are the youngest country in the world, right? We are 300 million people under the age of 18 in India, which is as good as the size of the whole of US. Imagine if we do not give them a right inspiration, right fitness, right healthcare tips, right sports mechanism in 5 years, 10 years, what kind of thing that we'll have? We'll have Delhi everywhere, unfortunately. Because the people do not have future to look forward to, we can give that future. That is what we can celebrate. So with that, I'm just going to close on with one small video, which is for the timing, it is not going to be more than 1 minute. Please listen to this video, understand what is happening.
If we show emotion, we're called dramatic. If we want to play against men, we're nuts. And if we dream of equal opportunity, delusional. When we stand for something, we're unhinged.
It's Sue Bird's gonna need to calm down.
When we're too good, there's something wrong with us. And if we get angry, we're hysterical, irrational, or just being crazy. But a woman running a marathon was crazy.
Officials tried to pull her off the course.
A woman boxing was crazy. A woman dunking? Crazy. Coaching an NBA team? Crazy. A woman competing in a hijab? Changing her sport? Landing a double cork 1080? Or winning 23 Grand Slams? Having a baby and then coming back for more? Crazy, 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 and crazy. So if they want to call you crazy, fine. Show them what crazy can do.
And they call me crazy. Thank you.